purposes only and not to be taken seriously. If you're easily offended, then leave the video now and go watch some other shit to get pissed off at. Alright, let's fucking do this.
First and foremost, let me explain something to you guys out there that are listening to this over here on the PW Hustle stupid little YouTube channel, whatever the hell you may call it. The fact of the matter is this. If it wasn't for me, if it wasn't for my thought process, if it wasn't for my ability to kind of push you idiots, yeah, I'm talking about you three jabronis, the founding fathers of the PW Hustle. Eight, Dick Brown. The pedophile Anthony Quintana, of course. The one and only Billy. The fact of the matter is this. If it wasn't for me showing you what it is to use social media, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, you guys would still be doing 45 downloads a month, maybe 50 on a good month.
He proposed to Nikki Bella, right? Said he would never do it, but he did it. Proposed to Nikki Bella. Everything is good. Storyline is set for Total Bellas so everybody can get interested. Are you paying attention to me? I'm saying this
I'm
for you.
I'm paying attention. You're looking at... There's a fly in my house the size of my damn head.
That's the lithium and the weed coming to. There is no fly. It's the winter. Okay? The flies aren't here right now.
The purple dragon.
Look at this dumbass. He's looking around. Are you okay? Do we need to stop this shit?
No, go ahead.
A giant purple fly flying around. Like, oh my god, I'll name it Barney. Stop the nonsense.
A hummingbird?
Over 50 women, then, now, and forever, will participate in an event called Evolution. And that event, I am privileged to announce, will be the first ever all women's pay-per-view.
Are you sure about that?
Impact did it first. What the fuck is WWE revolutionizing?
Oh, mama mia, I'm Ronaldo. Well, I'm on depression medication, and I have low self-esteem, so let me take a job working for the most tyrannical son of a bitch in the history of professional wrestling, Vince McMahon. Stupid. It was your decision to work for the WWE, and all you fucking idiots, you guys cannot think for yourselves. Hashtag Fire JBL. Everybody wants to jump on the Fire JBL bandwagon. All you are is stupid sheep. I'm tired of it. Fucking little keyboard warrior sitting in your mother's basement. The little cum towel right next to you, maybe a sock if you're lucky. How would you feel if one day you walked into your job establishment, into your stupid little break room, and put down your empty wallet? And then all of a sudden, you see post-its and pictures and signs everywhere saying fire Jamal, fire Susie, fire Ronaldo. Well, you could probably fire Ronaldo because he's Spanish, he probably steals everything, but that's neither here nor there.
We do got Jon Moxley, we know for a fact, is going to be in the G1. We know Shingo is going to be in the G1. So-called junior heavyweight, my ass. Dude looks like Tanahashi with time off.
He's freaking huge. I mean, I don't know why the hell he's a freaking junior heavyweight.
But, just because Bushi needed a tag partner for junior tag league.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Bushi needs help regardless. But, you know, that's a different story.
Poor Bushi. I love Bushi, but man, he is the jobber at LIJ. If Bushi in a tag match, Bushi taking the pin. That's how it's going to go.
And now, who fucking comes to New Japan? The motherfucking creator of the GTS.
You know what else we did notice? You know what else I noticed in particular? How not over Jay White was. So, you know,
So you want to start off by lying?
My man.
So you want to start off by lying?
Did I introduce this guy yet?
Okay.
Wow, it's so easy to trigger.
I see how it is.
I'm triggering 8-Track Brown like a Trump supporter gets triggered by Julian Assange. Listen, let me get this, 8-Track Brown. Let me get this, 8-Track Brown. Thank you very much. I appreciate your generosity in allowing me to get this out. Thank you so much, all right? Let's not get triggered there, Trickle Toast.
Call it form, guys. One guy speaks and the other guy retorts back.
Thank you, Professor. I appreciate you.
Every fucking year, when it's MLK Day, the WWE packs
pacifies us. They put these fucking MLK shits together and they pacify us. February, Black History Month is coming up, and guess what they're gonna do? They're gonna fucking pacify us. Show us shit about The Rock just to pacify us. Oh, I say it again. You've been had.
What?
You've been took.
What?
You've been hoodwinked.
What?
Bamboozled.
What?
Led astray.
What?
Run amok.
What?
This is what they fucking do. And you think I'm gonna be silent about it? Hell fucking no. You can kiss my ass and eat a fucking D-I-C-K, because I'm not falling for this shit. You ain't pulling the wool over my eyes, and I ain't falling for the motherfucking okey-doke. Get the fuck out of here.
All this aggravation and all these temper tantrums have spontaneously grown down the middle of Track's head. You can see like a white streak. He's becoming broken or woken like Matt Hardy. That's what happened to Matt Hardy. Now it's happening to A-Track Brown.
I've been broken long before this. When I saw Triple H beat Sting, I became broken. Yes, yes.
And I see it in your hair. Wait a minute.
Imbecile. You interrupted me. Don't ever let that happen again. Yes. You see, I did not sit on the pyramids of Giza. I have meditated with the Olmecs. I have compared my penis size to that of the god Min. I have rolled blunts with Imhotep.
How did that work out for you, bro? Actually, don't answer that question.
And I have also sparred with the great Shaka Zulu. And I can tell you that Triple H is no warrior. No. He's no warrior. He is nothing but a fallacy. He is a butt boy of the man they once called the Heartbreak Kid. So the man with three H's will continue to do what he always done, yes, and has put himself over on all the talent that he likes to bury with his golden shovel. And then he goes home and his wife rams him with her golden rod. You see how it all takes place? Because I'm woken!
That's how you do it. Oh God, that is disgusting. That is disgusting. There's literal saliva falling from your mouth right now. I know you meant that on purpose, but it was still very disgusting.
Bello, you put over Triple H, so for that, Bello, you're impotent. Change it. Stop putting over Triple H. Come on now.
I am not. That one fucking mark last week that pissed me off so much, I wish Daniel Bryan could have slapped the shit out of him, that big chubby bastard. I am not impotent. Yeah, right, dude. Find a mirror.
Man, so he comes out. It's boot out the building. We expected this. But not only that, Okada comes out to the biggest pop of the night, right? A ridiculous pop. I think it would rival anybody coming out of the WWE locker room, that pop that Okada got that night. Crazy. Okada. Okada.
Okada got the pop of the night.
I believe so. Are you listening? Are you okay? Listen, I'm gonna be about.
This is your world, baby. I'm just trying to get a nut. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead, speak,
listen,
daddy.
First of all, you're not getting a nut anywhere near me.
AJ is my America.
AJ's barely American.
The American the guy way. Is like AJ from, Styles.
He's barely from America. He's not even from here.
He's from Georgia.
He's from Japan, clearly.
Get the fuck out of here.
He won the IWGP heavyweight title. So he's probably from Japan.
Not the first American to drop a bomb and dominate that area.
Hey.
Oh, my God.
Watch it, Fisher. You be nice.
This podcast is brought to you by New Japan's destruction in Hiroshima.
Hey, tune in to Hidden Marsh this week when we cover the G1. The road to the G1.
King takes a big swig of that tequila, spits it in the face of Cole. By the way, if that was
baby real face turn,
if that was real tequila, I gotta tell you,
that was a baby face turn
for who?
For King.
How is that a baby face turn?
What's Conan wearing?
Clothes?
A fucking Red Sox hat. Good on King. Babyface turn. I'm down with the OGs now. Fuck Conan. Fuck Boston. Nope. I'm team OGs.
I didn't even realize that. He was really wearing a Boston Red Sox hat.
He was wearing a fucking Red Sox hat. I loved Conan, man. He's dead to me now.
Kota Ibushi can't see.
All right, so he got suplexed by freaking Ken.
Don't just say it like that.
It's true. How else you want me to say
it? He's not blind. He said he was having vision problems. He didn't say he was completely blind. Calm the fuck down. Don't jinx it.
How low can his eye get? He's Asian. What?
Oh, God.
That's true.
8-Track Brown Travis, if that is your real name, because you use so many different names on fucking social media. I don't know who the fuck you are. I had to block you one time. Because I didn't know who you were. Who are you? I'll tell you who you are. If you are the guy that if John Cena was standing in front of you with his sweaty, glistening pecs, you would take those two pecs and you would try to push them together and you would stick your little penis in between them and make man love to him. Why? Because secretly, you love John Cena. But guess what? Even if you don't love John Cena, Roman Reigns isn't going anywhere. He's the next Undertaker, motherfuckers. Deal with it.
Masked Man. Are we woken now? Remember, are you calm?
I'll tell you this.
The wokeness of Matt Hardy.
I'll tell you this. I'm more woken than Triple H's, because his dumbass is going around saying that we're not qualified to judge Roman Reigns. We're not qualified to judge Roman Reigns. I'll tell you this. I wouldn't have had his dumbass win the Royal Rumble 2 times in a row. 1 time in Philadelphia, you idiot. I wouldn't have done that. Then you're telling me that I'm not qualified to do it. And now Roman Reigns comes out to a chorus of boos. And what are you doing now? You put together the freaking Shield in hopes to get him over? Yeah, real nice. It's a Band-Aid, you dumbass. It's a Band-Aid. It's not going to work.
Not off to a great start in this match. Adam Cole and Random Rapper. What did you think about this entrance?
What the... Why? Why would you do that?
Like
the Undisputed Era song is like, I really dig it. Like, it's gotten to like NWO level for me now, where it's like I could just kind of put it on as background tunes, and it's like, yeah. And you always, no matter where it is in the song, you always hit the boom.
Yeah, always. Yeah.
You know, it's just cool. And then they ruined it. They just ruined
it. Random rapper, no one's ever heard of.
It didn't work for ROH, and it didn't work for NXT.
No.
You said that Enzo was going to freestyle. All I heard was the professor.
What do you mean?
I'm rapping.
That's not you?
That's not me.
Oh, my God. Yo, this motherfucker sounds like you trying to rap.
It's awful, bro.
And it's really fucking bad.
Oh, man. Right? It was your duty.
I would tell him don't quit his day job, but he's not a good wrestler either. So, wow. You said something earlier that I have to agree with, and that is that with the collection of hip-hop artists that are out now, you know, he is better, but that's not saying much. Not at all. It's like saying John Cena's good on the mic with the collection of mic workers they have in WWE. It ain't saying much. That shit was awful.
Yo, dude, and when...
I am going to tweet this motherfucker. Don't ever in your motherfucking life, as long as you live, pick up a fucking mic. And if he goes, oh, what do we got over here? A hater? I'm going to go, no, somebody who heard you freestyle... And
you see Rosenberg? Yo, Q, I just caught Rosenberg. Rosenberg is sitting there marking out. Like, Rosenberg should have literally told him, like, listen, alright, okay. And maybe but he's there bobbing his head. He's wearing a Monday Night, what the hell? Oh, Monday Night Rosenberg.
Night Rosenberg.
That's an awesome shirt. But regardless, he's just biting off of Kevin Owens and taking his shtick.
Bully Ray? Fuck you, dude. Fuck you. He has a history of acting like a bitch, an insecure jackass. I don't give a fuck. I guarantee you, I don't lie. I don't bullshit when it comes to me talking shit. I will gladly get my ass whooped because I know, first of all, I'm gonna give it my all, and two, while I'm getting my ass whooped, I'm still gonna talk shit. I would have told that fat fuck to kiss my fucking black ass. I fucking dare you to touch me, and I will sue your fucking ass off. And if you do touch me, you better kill me. Because if I'm able to walk, I'm going to catch up to you, and I'm going to fucking shoot your ass. The same man who sat there, we got a mother who taught her daughter how to suck dick.
I'm like, come on, man. You're the same dude who, you damn near invented this new level of savagery.
A-Track Brown, do you remember way back when you and I were sitting down on OneWrestling.com and Kevin Owens became the Universal Champion and we were live, and I sat there and I told all these marks, give me the sound effect, A-Track Brown. Tell them something.
You dumb motherfucking marks.
That's right, I'm talking to you. I sat there and told all the dumb motherfucking marks. A-Track Brown, give me another one. Come on.
You dumb motherfucking marks.
One more time.
You dumb motherfucking marks.
Read on.
You dumb motherfucking marks.
All right.
That's right.
I told them all. All right. With a tear in my eye. I sat there and I told you that Kevin Owens was going to be a mid-card champion. That's what I told her. And how much shit did I get for that 8-track, Brown?
Oh, you got a ton of shit, man. Yeah. You got a ton of shit. You got more shit than a fucking cow manure collector.
Yeah, people destroyed me for that. When Kevin Owens won the belt that night, oh, why you a hater, Masked Man? Masked Man, will you act like you never watched wrestling before? He's going to be the champion. He's going to be good. They're going to be... And what happened, 8-track, Brown? How did that turn out?
He was a mid-card champion, Heartbreak.
How about CM Punk, A-Track Brown?
Mid-card champion, Heartbreak.
Well, how about AJ Styles, A-Track Brown?
Still a mid-card champion, Heartbreak.
Thank you very much.
Just remember, when you fuck with the Godfather, you might get whacked.